Max Vermorken's with me from SigmaRoc in the studio this afternoon. Max, good to see you. Welcome along.
Thank you very much for having me.
Let's start off with the background here.
Yes.
Give us the history. You began trading on AIM back in January this year.
Absolutely. We acquired a subsidiary of the Lafarge-Holcim group called Rone, which is the construction materials leader in the market in the Channel Islands, in a £50 million raise. We bought the business because we knew it was a really high quality and solid asset to own, and a platform for us to start our expansion on. And so that's been trading on AIM since the 5th of January. The first half of the year was really focused on making sure that business was, you know, set up for us to be able to use it as a platform. The back office needed to be created. We needed to put the improvements in place we wanted to see. So all of that basically took up most of the first half.
You mentioned, well, building on that first half there, in terms of the numbers, the 6 months, 13 million in sales, so a strong period?
The sales were relatively all right. The markets there, the Jersey market is doing all right. The Guernsey market is still lagging a bit behind what it used to do. Yet the numbers that we put out are quite strong. We put a bit over 13 million in sales, 2.9 million EBITDA, which compares to 2 million for the first half last year, for like-for-like comparison. So all of that shows the improvements that we're putting through when we acquire a business.
And of course you've made pretty recently too this latest acquisition, Allen Concrete. Tell
Absolutely.
Me a bit more about them.
So the first half of this year was focused on making sure that the first business we bought was well settled in and runs like we wanted. And we then focused on a whole pipeline of other acquisitions we're looking at. And the first one to materialize is a company called Allen Concrete. They are a specialist wet cast concrete producer, so precast elements, based anything you find from fence posts and grid boards and bespoke ornaments outside. They're a very good and strong business with a site in London, site in the Midlands. Really, really nice company. In terms of value creation for us, it's a really good acquisition.
And how much did you pay for them?
We paid upfront 9 million in cash with a deferred consideration of 3.5. We do get a substantial a piece of industrial land in South London with it, which we can utilize for the business, but also for other activities. So all in all, a very good acquisition.
And you'd expect them to be earnings enhancing pretty quickly.
Oh, they are already. If we look at what the brokers, for instance, Berenberg have put out, they say that earnings per share accretion is probably about 50% next year. So from that perspective, we're extremely happy.
Looking ahead outside the Channel Islands, outside the UK, you're looking for opportunities further abroad?
Absolutely. So we are a buy and build story in the construction materials sector. So it remains a very fragmented industry. That's because the product is very local. It's nearly town or region based, and the producers are therefore nearly town and region based. And so if you look at the UK and Northern Europe, Benelux, Germany, Northern France, there's quite a lot of businesses out there which are very, very interesting for us to acquire, improve, and then drive shareholder value.
And those are markets you know particularly well, are they?
Well, I'm from these regions. The board is from, a proportion of the board is from that region, but that's not enough. You really need to have lived there and operated there so that you know the local granularity of the market, because otherwise you can't get in as a total outsider.
Absolutely. Well, break it down for us. In terms of weighing up businesses, what's the criteria you look for? What do they need to have?
Well, we are very specific in terms of what we look for. We want something that is a business that has some kind of a unique feature which will always underpin its value, whether that is a specific technology or a specific location or a deposit, something that will underpin the value of that asset for long term. Which is exactly what we did with Rone and with Allen Concrete. We also wanted to be a higher margin business, higher than the average in the industry, simply to, you know, a pound invested in that will generate a higher return for the investors. And then we want to be able to improve it somewhere, do something to it that we can increase the profitability altogether, which then should make a very attractive story for the shareholders.
And you mentioned that strong pipeline of opportunities you've got. You reckon we might not be too far off news of a further acquisition?
We're hard at work. We've looked at 13 businesses to date. We've obviously bought three so far. There's about five or six that we disqualified, again, because they didn't meet our criteria. But the pipeline continues growing every month, especially since we refocused our team's efforts since the half-year mark fully on next transactions. That's the activity there is quite significant, yeah.
And you've got quite a decent debt facility there. Should something cross your table that you like?
Absolutely. Santander has been very good to help us along. We've got 9 million in the facility that we've currently have, and they look to stay with us for the future. So we're well positioned from that perspective.
And in terms of your shareholder base, a significant amount of institutional backing.
Absolutely, there's quite a few institutions there in our shareholder base, legal in general and so on, which we're very happy with. Mm-hmm. But obviously, private investors should get involved now because it's a good story, I think.
Well, and that good story, I'll leave the final word to you. Why do you reckon private investors should get involved?
There is another company called Summit out in the US. They've done something similar to us. They started about 5-6 years ago from zero, and they're £3.5 billion now. And that's simply because the industry remains a very fragmented industry, a lot of smaller players dotted across quite a large region. You can acquire these businesses at attractive valuations if you do your homework and then improve them and integrate them. And that's exactly what we're about. And if you look at what's been done like this elsewhere, there's quite I'm certainly positive.
You're positive. Hey, Max, good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you very much.